Sony has revealed the first details of the brand new PlayStation 5, giving us a sneak peek at what we can expect from the next generation console. In an interview with Wired, the console's architect, Mark Cerny, assured us all that the PlayStation 5 wouldn't merely be an upgrade to previous versions of the famed console. While both Microsoft and Sony have milked the Xbox One and PlayStation 4 consoles with the likes of the Xbox One S and PS4 Pro, Cerny said this time that's not the case. He said, "The key question is whether the console adds another layer to the sorts of experiences you already have access to, or if it allows for fundamental changes in what a game can be." According to Cerny, for the PlayStation 5, it's the latter. The forthcoming console doesn't yet have an official name, although PlayStation 5 Fit would surely be the most logical, meaning Cerny has simply referred to the exciting new gadget as the company's next-gen console. The console will feature a new AMD CPU, which Cerny explained will allow for 3D audio with no extra hardware. As a game, it's been a little bit of a frustration that audio did not change too much between PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 4, he said. With the next console, the dream is to show how dramatically different the audio experience can be when we apply significant amounts of hardware horsepower to it. This means you'll feel more immersed in the game as sounds come at you from all around. Backwards compatible with the PlayStation 4, with games released on both platforms until the new console has been fully established on the market, the new machine will also be compatible with PSVR. VR is very important to us, Cerny said. But, as well as all that, there's something else Cerny has said is both the key to the next generation and a true game changer: the hard drive. The new solid-state drive, SSD, also packs a punch. According to Wired, fast traveling between locations in Insomniac's Spider-Man on a Picosecond 4 Pro took 15 seconds, but using a next-gen PlayStation DevIt, the same action took just 0.8 seconds. The only downside? Let's just say there's no point expecting the console to land in stores at any point this year. Perfection takes time, after all.